Welcome back to Trend Wins Bastard Bonds. Today is September 28th, 2016, and this time I've got the right save. I will have edited out the other stuff. I noticed that the fragmented fortress and the woodland were not sparkling, so that means I must not have cleared them lately. Yet I distinctly remember just going through them. I remember something actually that I played this game. You know, I'm finally getting caught back up again on my editing. Aside from Deus Ex, which I think I'm going to have to take a break for that just for a little while so I can get stuff done. I'm not sure. If I don't have anything on Friday for Deus Ex, that just means that I am behind on that so that I can catch up on everything else. I did want to check out the guard outpost. An old guard post along the road. It appears to be in good shape, so it may still have supplies inside if you can find a way in. So I'm still sick. I've been sick for like the past 3 or 4 months between my between the job I have and having 2 kids. I think I'm going to be sick for like the next 4 years. Well, that was, under this metric, this is knife. Who knows how long it's been here? That's a special weapon. It's special in that I think it's fairly unique. A nice stockpile of tier 2 weaponry. Should be it. That was a very small area, but not bad. I mean, I came here specifically because of the Bitter Blade, but the other stuff is not a bad trade-off. Let me think here. Fortress Foundation. Oh, it did lead somewhere near. It has 6 gnolls, but Grant has some dialogue if you bring him. Fortress Foundation. This old fortress is barely more than a shell, but it seems sturdy, and is large enough to shelter a small army. Specifically, it can support 50 people if you have upkeep of 24,000. Now, this place has 6 gnolls, and if I ransom them, I'll get some bludgeons. So... huh. Alright. Ugh, gross. This place smells like gnolls. Keep an eye out. I probably should have brought someone with plenty of fight, then, to convince the gnolls to surrender. So why do I do that real fast? Let me back out. Let's try this again. I swapped out the kind of people I brought into the guard post to grab things, and the different team as here as well.
Ugh, gross. This place smells like gnolls. Keep an eye out.
Stop!
I know, Ken.
Hold on, let me try. I'm trying to think of what this gnoll might sound like. Now, I think of them like some sort of like kobold type canine creature, but these look like more like burly wolfmen. So.
Stop! I know, Ken, win! No can have his mind!
That wasn't very productive.
Oh.
That's probably the place I need to go to if I want bludgeons. Charge! Alright, there we go. There's the remaining three. Pretty sure there's nothing else, but I'm just checking just to make sure. The only reason I have to think there's nothing else is because the guy doesn't indicate anything else. But it might not be perfect. It's a very good guide, and I'm glad I have it. But you should always, you know, check for yourself on certain things. Alright, so there wasn't much there. I got 6 bludgeons, however, which is great. That is what I like. Probably put things on Philippus since he's done for his. He's pretty much used up his expedition, I guess. You know, assuming each person gets like one run or something before they are put away. Basically, I want to run a person one time, so that way when I go back to base, it's maximizing in-game days. And I get more bonds this way. Remember that you're traveling on the world map and entering an area constitutes an in-game time period. Not that it should really amount to much. That wasn't very much conversation there, but all right. This is what I would consider, like, a very awesome team. I haven't really put them to use yet, so it remains to be seen how awesome they really are. Let's try out the underground town. This old mine appears to have been converted into a town of sorts, but it's unclear as to whether anyone is still here. Let's zoom out real fast, using the party function to get a good screenshot. If you zoom out, the text at the top isn't totally synchronized with how it normally is, I think. It doesn't matter too much for you, but it does matter if, for example, you're trying to merge two different screenshots together, which is what I've had to do sometimes. When I forget to take a screenshot appropriately, I'll try to mishmash the map together so that's accurate for you. Not that you can see it behind all the text, but hey. It's, I guess maybe the thought that counts? Alright. Now, I expected something behind that final alleyway. These dudes are slow. Telekinetic yet? Alright. I doubt there's gonna be another thing where I need the white truffle, but hey. Alright. All the side routes are checked out. Let's check out these rooms. Knock knock! Pizza delivery! Man, these guys are slow. Hopefully, they'll get a little faster with time. I assume I need more hunt or dodge or something, that they'll get to pick up some speed. So let's actually see what a phantom has. If I ransom him, I'll get a diamond. You know what, I don't even think Ectoplast drops anything good. I was just kind of getting the... Yeah, he drops an Elixir Vitae, which is okay. Since I already got him down there, I might as well see if he'll surrender. Although it doesn't help that I made Rashad defend. I thought the Goblin Mage is capable of communicating, but alright. Especially when he screams, "Hate you, hate you." Oh wait, it's probably because the character I had is mindless. Let me see here. Now, there's no mindless trait up here, but that's fine. I guess it makes sense. Although it's... Huh. Well, I learned something there. Them, but I figured if I did hit them with Rashad, I might as well do it. And I guess we're done here. Movement increased by one and fleet. I hear stealth, by the way, is bugged and you can move forever. It might just be that I need fleet if I want those steel exarchs to get anywhere in a timely manner. Is that the only thing that increases my movement by one? It might be. Alright, well, whatever. This was dark and not listed as master, or this was dark when first leveled up, but after the first level up after I got the last pip, it was still dark. It didn't even matter, but I had trouble getting that out for some reason. Alright, so what are you guys like? You have a 5 attack, alright, but you're mostly defense, which is fine. That's what I hired you guys for, is defense. So I don't really know what I'm going to do with these guys. I'm probably just first level them up to like get some speed, because they don't do me any good as guards if they can't get to the front. I now have a paladin soul. And bring that along. Where's Inquisitor's End? Oh, do the monsters don't respawn if you don't clear it up? Huh. Alright, well. You come seeking power, as did the demons, but the power garden herein belongs only to those with the discipline to use it wisely. Make an offering of the paladin soul? Oh, I have to offer it? Alright, let's find out. Yes, your discipline is bound within the myriad folds of this steel pearl. Go then, Crusader, with this symbol of the righteous, and scour this land. Inside the chest, sitting in its velvet casing, is a magnificent gilded hammer, thrumming with warm, soothing energy. Well, that looks pretty sweet. Crusader, wrist strike 30, physical 50, regeneration 10. Let me try comparing that to the other weapon, though. Give me a second. I'm gonna be lame like that. Let's see, meteoric is the other item. So what's meteoric like? It is wrist strike 100. Whoa! Okay, let's do meteoric instead. Alright, so we'll come back for this Crusader some other time. But I'm gonna save my paladin soul, and I'm gonna come back for that.